Now we'll see the third mean value theorem, that is the Cauchy's mean value theorem. What is the Cauchy's mean value theorem? So there is one more extra function is there. Okay, so one more function was g is there. There are two functions. So f and g continued on closed interval a b and differential on open interval a b. Same thing here, what g is added only here. Okay, for Rolle's value theorem, f is a continued on closed interval a b and differential on open interval a b. Lagrange mean value theorem, there is also f is continued on a b and differential on open interval a b is there. One more function is added here, g is added here, and there is one more extra condition of g is also that, so your g prime x not equal to 0 for all x. This extra condition is on g is there. Okay, for Rolle's mean value theorem, so there is what, f of a is equal to f of b. Here what, g prime, so derivative is not equal to 0. Okay, derivative is not equal to 0 in open interval a b. Okay, so this is the main condition here, g prime x not equal to 0, because what, your derivative, your g prime c is here now at the denominator, your denominator is not equal to 0, therefore it is verified now here. Okay, so this will be well defined here, g prime c not equal to 0. Also g of a is not equal to g of b, note that g of a is not equal to g of b, because what happened if g of a is equal to g of b? So if g of a is equal to g of b, then what, g is the continued on closed interval a b, differentiable on open interval a b, g of a is equal to g of b, that means what, g satisfies the Rolle's mean value theorem. Okay, so g satisfies Rolle's mean value theorem, that means there exists c belong to open interval a b such that g prime c is equal to 0, but g prime c is not equal to 0 because c for x is all, for all x belong to open interval a b, your g prime x not equal to 0, that means g prime c is equal to 0. This is false. Okay, this is the contradiction to the fact that g prime x not equal to 0. So therefore what, g of a and g of b, they are also not same. So that means this is the denominator not 0, it is well defined. G prime c is not equal to 0, this is also well defined. Okay, so that means g of b minus g of a not equal to 0. So that means what, this part is well defined here. Okay, so you know that. So what we'll do, we want to prove this one. So we'll consider the function part, define all closed interval a b such that phi of x is equal to this. Okay, so we'll find phi prime x also. Phi prime x is equal to f prime x minus f of b minus f of a upon g of b minus g of a into g prime x. This will be your problem. Now see that f is a continuous, f and g are continuous on closed interval a b and differentiable on open interval a b. So this implies that phi is also continuous on closed interval a b and differentiable on open interval a b, because what, the sum of the function, sum of two continuous functions is continuous, sum of product of two continuous functions is continuous. This is what the sum now. This f of a is the constant here. This g of a, this is the constant here. Okay, so that means this is sum or difference of two continuous functions is continuous. Okay, so by that rule, your phi is continuous. Okay, so what is the phi of a? Phi of a. So phi of a is what? F of a minus f of a. This is zero. Okay. So now phi of a, f of a, okay, so f of a minus f of a is 0, g of a minus g of a is 0. So phi of a is equal to 0. Okay, phi of b now, what is phi of b? F of b minus f of a minus, see this is g of b minus g of a, so g of these get cancelled, then minus f of b minus f of a minus, this minus become plus, so get cancelled. So this is what, phi of b. So therefore phi satisfies, right, Rolle's conditions. So therefore by Rolle's theorem, there exists c belong to open interval a b such that g prime phi prime c is equal to 0. So what is phi prime c then? What is phi prime c? We have calculated phi prime x now. So that is what phi prime c is equal to 0. That means what? F prime c is equal to f of f prime c minus, this is minus, minus f of b minus f of a upon g of b minus g of a into g prime c is equal to 0. So we shift this to this side to this side. So what we get? Then we get this is equal to this. Okay. Now g prime c not equal to 0. Therefore you can divide by this. Because what? You are given that g prime x not equal to 0 for all x belong to opposite to ab. So therefore you can shift g prime c here. This is what? F of b minus f of a upon g of b minus g of a. You may write this is equal to f of a minus f of b, but you have to write here g of a minus g of b. Okay, this option will be also correct. Okay, you may write this is f of a minus f of b upon g of a minus g of b while solving the problem. Both the things are same here. Both the things are same here. Note this. Okay, so we'll verify question that verify Cauchy's mean value theorem. Verify Cauchy's mean value theorem for the functions f of x is equal to x square, g of x is equal to x cube on closed interval 1, 2. Find C. By Cauchy's mean value theorem, we have to find C now. Okay, so solution. Okay, so we'll take a derivative. F of x is equal to twice x. G prime x is equal to 3x square. Okay, so see these f and g are polynomial. Polynomial functions are always continuous and differentiable. Okay, so f and g are continuous on closed interval 1, 2 and differentiable on open interval 1, 2. Okay, so now g prime x also not equal to 0 for all x belongs to open interval 1, 2. Okay, because g prime x is what? 3x square. So it is 0 only when x is equal to 0, but 0 is not there. Okay, so f prime c upon g prime c is equal to f of 2 minus f of 1 upon g of 2 minus g of 1. You cannot write this word g prime not equal to 0. Okay, so note that this. So here also f prime not equal to 0, you may write the reciprocal also, because your f prime is also not equal to 0. You can take any f and you can take any g now. Okay, so you have to take the denominator such way that your derivative is not vanish. Okay, you should do this. So f prime c is what then? This is twice c upon 3c square upon 3c square. What is f of 2? F of 2 is 4 minus f of 1. F of 1 is 1. So this is what? 8 minus 1. Okay. So this is what then? 2 by 3c. So this is what? 3 by 7. This is 3 by 7. Okay. So that is what then? C. You take the reciprocal. 3 by c upon 2 is equal to 7 by 3. So c is equal to what then? 14 by 9. 14 by 9 means this is what? It is not less than 2. It is less than 2. Okay? And it is also greater than 1. It is greater than 1. So this is belong to open interval 1, 2. So the value of c is what here? The value of c is very important here. 14 by 9 is the your required value of c. Okay? So we will take problems on it of the exercise. Here the crucial part is to find the value of c only. Okay, so we'll take f of x is equal to e raised to x and g of x is equal to e raised to minus x on closed interval ab. Okay, so exponential function is continuous, differentiable, no problem for this one. Just we will find f prime x now. This is e raised to x. G prime x is what? Minus e raised to minus x. Exponential function cannot be 0. Exponential function cannot be 0. It is seen here. So on AB, it is not equal to 0 also, because this is not 0, okay? Exponential function cannot be 0. E raised to minus infinity is 0, note that, okay? So, F and G are continued on closed interval AB, differentiable on open interval AB. Also, your G prime X not equal to 0 for all X belongs to open interval AB, it will not be 0. Okay? Now, we'll do this. We'll find C value of C. G prime C is equal to F of B minus F of A upon G of B minus G of A. We'll do this. So, F prime C what? E raised to C minus E raised to minus C is equal to F of B dot E raised to B minus E raised to A upon E raised to minus B minus E raised to minus A. Okay? So, this is what then? Minus 2 E raised to, not minus 2, E raised to twice C. This is E raised to twice C. Now, this is E raised to B minus E raised to A upon 1 upon E raised to B minus 1 upon E raised to A. Okay? So, this is what? E raised to twice C only. Okay? E raised to A minus E raised to B. I have shifted this minus to this side, to this way. And what is the denominator then? E raised to A minus E raised to B upon E raised to A into E raised to B. Okay? So, this is what then? E raised to twice C is equal to what? E raised to A minus E raised to B. Okay? This. Into divided by E raised to A plus B upon E raised to A minus E raised to B. So, this gets cancelled now. Okay? So, E raised to twice C is equal to E raised to A into E raised to B is nothing but the E raised to A plus B. So, here what then? Twice C is equal to A plus B. So, C is equal to A plus B. So, that means what here? Therefore, so now A plus B upon 2. This is A plus B upon 2. And this is belongs to open interval AB. No problem for this one. Because this is arithmetic mean. So, therefore what? C is arithmetic mean between A and B. So, C is the arithmetic mean between A and B. So, note that if the question is that E raised to X and E raised to minus X, then C is the arithmetic mean between A and B. By Cauchy's mean value theorem, C is the arithmetic mean between A and B. Note this. Okay, so in exponential function there, remember the arithmetic mean now. So there are three types of the mean. Arithmetic mean, root AB is the geometric mean between A and B, and 2 upon 1 upon A plus 1 upon B. So that means twice AB upon A plus B is nothing but harmonic mean between A and B. Twice AB upon A plus B will be the harmonic mean between A and B. So, note this. So, such type of the three means are there. Arithmetic mean, geometric mean and harmonic mean. Okay. So, we do one more problem. So, we will see what happened for this one then. So, your f of x is equal to root x. G of x is equal to 1 upon root x. So, your interval is AB. So, A is greater than 0. Obviously, B is also greater than 0. Okay. A is strictly greater than 0. Okay, so we have given this, okay? We'll find f prime x, 1 upon 2 root x. So, g prime x, 1 upon something is what? Minus 1 upon something square, into derivative of something, into derivative of root x. So, that is 1 upon 2 root x. So, this is minus 1 upon 2x root x, okay? So, this is the derivative of this one, okay? So, now this is what? X is positive, okay? So, both are well defined. It is greater than 0, that means what here, your denominator will not be 0. So, both f and g are differentiable and continued. F and g are continued on closed interval AB and differentiable on open interval AB. Also, g prime x not equal to 0 for all x belongs to open interval AB. This is very important, g prime x. Okay? Because for Cauchy's mean value theorem, g prime x not equal to 0. So, if this g prime x will be 0, then if it is not equal to 0, call this as g of x and call this as f of x. Then change the role of f and g then. Okay? So, now f prime c upon, you have to verify this. Okay? So that means you have to prove that your C is diabetic. So don't write by Cauchy's mean value theorem there exists C. You have to show that there exists C belong to opponent to the visor that is. Okay. So F prime C is equal to F of B. Okay. F of B minus F of A upon G of B minus G of A. You may write F of A minus F of B upon G of A minus A. Okay. Okay. So that is the your part actually. 1 upon 2 root C. Okay. So minus 1 upon C, 2 root, twice C, C root C, 1 upon 2 C root C, that is minus sign is important here. This is what root B minus root A upon 1 upon root B minus 1 upon root A. Okay, so here what value will be 1 upon root 2 root C, 1 upon 2 root C is there. So this is minus 1 upon C, this will be minus 1 upon. So this will what then root B minus root A into, so this is what is root A root B into root A minus root B. So this you have to take the reciprocal, that means what you have to take the change, you have to take the reciprocal of the difference. This will be the reciprocal of the difference. Okay, now this get cancelled, this get cancelled. So 1 upon C will be, this get cancelled, this is what this is your A, this is your minus A, and minus is there. So this is 1 by C is equal to 1 by C is equal to root A root B. Oh, this is not C. This is not C. This is minus C. Okay. So your C will be root A into root B. So C is equal to root A B. See, this is upon 1 upon this. 1 upon 2 root C, 1 upon 2 get cancelled. Then this is 1 upon minus 1 by C is there. So minus 1 by C is at the denominator. So this becomes minus C. Okay. And this minus becomes, this is what, this if you want to shift the minus sign here, this is root A minus root B, and this get cancelled. So minus this also get cancelled. So C is equal to root AB. So this is belong to open interval AB, because this is a geometric mean. So C is geometric mean between A and B. So if the question is that root X and 1 upon root X, then C is what? The geometric, by Cauchy's mean value theorem, C is the geometric mean between A and B. Okay? So remember this. Suppose your F of X is equal to X cube, and tan inverse x is equal to g of x is tan inverse x, your interval is 0 1, your interval is 0 1. Okay, so what is f prime x? F prime x is 3x square. What is g prime x? 1 tan inverse, so 1 upon 1 plus x square. Okay, so when it will be 0, it will not be 0 for any value of x. So your g prime x is not equal to 0. Now tan inverse is what exists in the interval 0 1 everywhere. X cube is a polynomial, no problem for this one. Okay, so f and g are continuous on closed interval 0 1, differentiable on open interval 0 1. Okay, and g prime x not equal to 0 for all x belong to open interval 0 1. Okay, so this is hold. Now we have to verify the Cauchy's mean value theorem. That means we have to prove that the C is open interval AB. So we have to consider this F prime C upon G prime C. F prime C upon G prime C. We have already calculated the derivative. So this is what? F of 1 minus F of 0 upon G of 1 minus G of 0. You may write F of 0 minus F of 1 upon G of 0 minus G of 1. Okay, so what is F prime C? So 3C square. What is G prime C? 1 upon 1 plus C square. Is equal to, what is f of 1 is 1 minus 0. What is g of 1? Tan inverse of 1 is pi by 4. This is pi by 4 minus 0. Okay, so 3c square into 1 plus c square is equal to 4 by pi, is equal to 4 by pi. Okay, so I think the problem becomes very complicated. Thank you. So c square into 1 plus c square is equal to 4 by 3 pi. Something is wrong. So 3c square, okay? So this is correct. 1 plus c square is also correct. So f of 1 is 1 cube is 1, 0. Tan inverse of 0 is 0. Tan inverse of 1 is pi by 4. So 4 upon pi is correct. So actually what this is, what c raised to 4 plus c square minus 4 upon 3 pi is equal to 0. This is quadratic in c square, so this becomes complicated, very complicated actually. Okay, so we leave it. Okay. Okay, these problems are enough for you. Okay, so now we'll stop here. Thank you.